114 chapters in the Holy Quran, 114, and every chapter, the first verse is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, except for Surah Tawbah. Surah Tawbah is repentance, Surah number 9, because it starts off Bara'atu min Allahi wa Rasulih, that immunity, it is about the punishment, or that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forsakes the ones who forsake Him. So therefore it doesn't start with Bismillah, but every chapter other than Surah number 9 starts with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim in the Holy Quran. So this verse Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim has appeared 114 times in the Holy Quran, 113 times before the surahs, before every chapter except for one, and it has appeared in Surah Naml, Surah number 27, the ant, twice, once in the beginning, once in the middle, where a bird, a woodpecker or something, flies from Nabi Sulaiman, Solomon, King Solomon, to the queen of Saba. Yes? And he goes to her, takes the letter from Sulaiman, and he says, Innahu min Sulaimana. This letter is from Sulaiman. Innahu bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And this letter reads, and when he starts, it says, it starts with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So Bismillah was not only specific to the Holy Prophet, and it's not only just given to Muslims, that it was given to the prophets before the Holy Prophet as well. So it read Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. It started off with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So 114, and you should make a habit of saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim before everything. The Holy Prophet ﷺ says, "Kullu amrin dhi balin lam yubtada bi Bismillah." Bismillah fahuwa abtar. Any affair that is important to you, that has any importance, and you do not start it with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, then it has no end. It is without any results, without any good outcome. So always start everything with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Start eating your food with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Your lesson with Bismillah. And in short, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is called Basmala. Basmala is Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Or Hayqala is La Hawla Wa La Quwwata Illa Billah. Or Takbir is Allahu Akbar. It's called Takbir. Or Tasbih, Subhanallah, is called Tasbih. Or Hayhala, La Ilaha Illallah, is called Hayhala. So these are short forms. So before everything, before you go to bed, before you go out of the house, before you leave your house, before you start your speech, before everything, before you start your lesson, before you start teaching, always say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Make a habit, and then there will be barakat in it when you call Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Rahman ar-Rahim. And the riwayat say that as soon as a child says Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the tradition say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives the parents, because the child has said Bismillah ar-Rahman, in the name of Allah I seek help, in the name of Allah the beneficent, the merciful, or the most beneficent, the most merciful, or the most compassionate, the most merciful. So here ba has 9 meanings in Arabic, and one of them is for seeking help, for isti'ana, for seeking help. And one of them is to begin, to faribtada. So I begin in the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful, or I seek help from the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful. So whatever you want to say. So always start everything with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has repeated this verse so many times in the Holy Quran. And it is a part of every surah it appears before. There are 3 views amongst our Sunni brothers. They believe it is not a part of any surah, one view. Second view is it is a part of only Surah Fatiha. And third view amongst them is it is a part of every surah, but it is not a complete ayat before every surah, it is a part of the ayat. And the fourth view is of Ja'fari school of thought, Imam Sadiq alayhi salam. We believe it is a part of every surah except for Surah Tawbah, and it is a complete verse before every surah.